Hello everybody and welcome back to the XsivGaming channel and Farm Simulator 2017. This is our Let's Play series on Coldborough Park Farm, and today we are up to episode number 6. So if you could quickly drop us a like, it would be much appreciated. And of course, if you are new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. So, episode 6, what are we up to today? Yeah, you guessed it, we're back down here at the store again. Got the Ultra here. Back down at the store. And what we're going to be purchasing today is something from the new Kuhn DLC, Kuhn. And we're going into Balin. And we're going to go across to, the Kuhn SW4014, £54,000. And it is a bale wrapper that will wrap square and round bales. Of course, that'll turn them into silage bales, which means they'll be ideal for feeding the cows, etc. Which we haven't actually got any yet. Anyway, so what we're going to do is purchase that. We can actually select the different foil colour we want. We've got white, black, pink, or what appears to be a very pale green. So I think we're going to go with the pale green today. So even though you're not actually paying any extra for the colour, you can customise it, I believe, at the store once you've purchased it. So we're going to buy that now. That's that purchased. Let's have a quick look at it. Yep, so here we go. So it definitely looks more like a green colour. But this is the Kuhn SW 4014 auto load. We have actually trialled this on a previous video where we showed some of the DLC content. But we're going to be using this today. So there we go, that's what it looks like. We'll jump into the Vultra and get it all connected up, but before we do that, if we head on over to this corner over here, we've got Ross Market Auctioneers, and this is where we can purchase our cows, pigs and sheep, etc. So this is the cattle market. A few people wandering around here. There's the sheep, a bit noisy. So there we go. That is the cattle market. And what we'll be doing is actually going in and having a word with the owner, Mr. Ross. Because if we look at the cost of animals, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 pounds each. Plus we've got delivery on top of that, we'll be having a quiet word with the auctioneer and seeing if we can get a discounted price if we buy bulk, of course. But that is in another episode. But today we are focusing on the Kuhn SW4014. So we'll jump into the Vultra, get it started up, get the wrapper connected up. And as I say, this can do the square bales and the round bales. All this opens up. Get up to field number 22 where we've got some bales ready. may remember from episode number 4 where we did all baling. Turn left here. Left here into Chantry Farm. Head down. Okay, so unfold this. It all stretches out like so. And all we need to do is line up with the bale, drive into it. Collect the bale off the floor for us and start wrapping it. You can see the rollers massage the bale around to turn it, cut the wrap, and then we can hit the unload button and it drops it back down. And then, of course, line up for the next one. Again, it'll pick it up, massage it all round. The animation on this wrapper is excellent, including the cutting of the wrap. Is the square bales. That's how we do them. Get more wrap. Questioned by a lot of people, especially a lot of the console users, is it actually worth purchasing the Kuhn DLC? A lot of equipment you can get anyway, using the standard equipment to do the job. Yeah, I think it is worth purchasing the DLC just for the square bale wrapper. It's the first time we've had square bale wrapper in Farm Simulator, so it's worth that. The animations are very good. Going to wrap half of this field, as we do of course need the hay for sheep as well. Cows also need some hay, so I think we'll call it a day on the field there. to fold that up for a second. Now, behind us, we've actually took the liberty of cutting the grass in the cow pen. It's not something that you would normally do. The cows would obviously eat it. But yeah, we've cut it because there's no cows here at the moment, and we valve it up using a round baler. And I wanted to test this wrapper out on the round bales. See how it all works. There we go, so it's obviously better to come in the other way. Yeah, and it doesn't massage it round, it just rolls it round. And then you unload the same. So, yeah, that is very, very good. Rolls away. Got that one down there as well. I noticed that bales do tend to like to roll a lot more now. Hopefully you're enjoying today's video. It is going to be a relatively short video, as we do have an awful lot to get done this weekend. Today's episode was mostly about showing you the Kuhn bale wrapper. Yes, excellent piece of kit. Animation's good, and I really like it. Let's second a bit quick. One wants to be a bit awkward. So we've got it out of the bush. Quickly get the wrapper connected back up. Line it up. There we go. I do believe that's the last one in this little field here. So there we go, that is the Kuhn Bale wrapper. Get it folded up, look. It's nice and tidily away. And there we go. So we get this put back into the shed now. I mean, this all goes with this kind of equipment here, we might as well store it in here. And there we go. So that's that all tidied away. So next up we need to get all of our bowels collected and tidied. Now to do this, easiest option, so if we come along here, we've obviously still got plenty of square barrels to be collected. I'm going to nip to the store and collect the auto stacker, square baler auto stacker, as it will take us quite a while to get them all stacked up. So I shall see you in just a tick. Okay, so welcome back. We're back at Chantry Farm. We've got the Cousin Auto Stacker, Square Paler Auto Stacker. Squeeze it into the build, it is quite long. Get the table out and collect the bales up. So what we're going to do is collect up all the square sided bales. This will give us plenty of cow food when we are ready. So that's all of those. Now, for the purposes of today and getting everything tidied up, we are going to just stack everything up here in the corner. Of course, back our trailer correctly. Don't want to damage the trailer because we've only leased it. That's got to go back. Just thought we'd use it just out of quickness for today. And of course, we don't want to pierce all the bags, all the wraps. Them up. Let's see how far back we can get this without driving through the bush. We'll unload the bales there. Lower the table back down. And you can see the bales reset themselves. Side table comes up. We're of course going to put that back down because we want to collect up all of the rest of the hay bales. And we probably could have done a few more, packed a few more, but not to worry. Session this one right up here, look. Can get 16 bales on this in one go. Of course, with this many bales stacked right up, we are going to need a telehandler. So we'll be looking at one of those very, very soon. Field. This edge so they are out of the way. Stable. The table's still resetting itself. Yeah, we're ready to collect the rest. Hopefully we have got all the bales now. I believe we have 7 more on there. Probably wasn't wise to stack them bales so high. will do is get a telehandler at some point. So, there we go. Turn that off there, leave it all connected up. That is our bales. Some good hay bales there. Some nice solid silage bales there. Hold the gate up for the time being. And as we come down back into the main chantry farm area where the cows would be, we've got a good few round silage bales as well in their green wrap. Of course, the next job will be to get some animals and get those bales collected off there. But today's episode really was all about the Kuhn SW4014. So the bale wrapper there. So I think that's going to be it for today's episode. If you have enjoyed this video, if you could just drop us a quick like, it'd be much appreciated. And of course, if you are new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. But yeah, that's going to be it for today. Thank you very much for watching, and we shall see you in the next episode. Bye for now.